A child can choose any subject of his choice. Don't apply pressure on your children to become an IITian, a doctor, an engineer, or a rank holder, a gold medalist. They can do wonders even if they don't get seat in a prestigious college. For your information, I'm sure you have been reading paper recently. Satya Nadella has been posted as the CEO of Microsoft, who didn't get seat in IIT. He didn't get seat in NIT. He didn't get seat in Bitsfiller. He didn't get seat in any government college. Finally, he joined in a private college in Manipal. And today, he's the CEO. Under him, there are thousands of IITians and all top, the cream of the world are working. Take another case, Suri, CEO of Nokia, latest CEO of Nokia. He also didn't get seat in IIT, NIT or anything. He had his education in Mangalore, a payment seat, and today he's the CEO. And you all know about Vipro Premji, who is a college dropout. And Krishnada Krishnan, Infosys CEO. Right to this man. And he wanted to become a doctor. He wrote his entrance exam. He didn't get seat in medicine from Kerala. He was disappointed, frustrated. Then his father is a great man. He motivated him and got him joined in BSc. After BSc, he joined in Infosys and he rose to the top level. Friends, here, parents, we have a big role to play. Today happened to be Father's Day. I request all the fathers to follow 6 P's when you are with your children. Almost in a unified council, in every session, I've been telling them, but since the parents are changed here, the new parents, I would like to repeat this. 6 P's. Six T's. First T is time. Your child wants to talk to you. Your daughter wants to talk to you. Your son. Never say, I am busy. Even President of America, although he is controlling the whole, he has time to spend time with his children. Today, you read the statement given by Obama. He said, parenting is an art. I want to give better childhood to my children, unlike me. He had troubles. Steve Jobs had troubles. He was given to others. So friends, our main business is not to see what is dimly at a distance, but to do what clearly lies at hand. Give time to your child. He wants to talk to you. Your son, your daughter got an award here, and I appreciate the parents who have come here all the way from your place to this place. This, in one way, it gives them courage, a sort of motivation, and also his outlook will be broadened. Never say, I am busy. A busy man always finds leisure. Bill Clinton, when he was President of America, he used to spend 2 days with children. And once in a way, he used to go to Monica, that we don't know. But he never used the word busy. For busy people, I suggest 3D. program, 3 days, deal, certain things you have to deal, certain things delegate, and 3rd day is dump. So 1st T is time, 2nd T is talk. When your child stops talking to you, you talk to him. Since you are not talking, mom is not spending time, she is sharing her ideas with the neighbor's boy. Why the children are addicted to Facebook? They are making friendship with unknown people. They are all need-based friends. But when there are love-based friends at home, why they are not spending time? Because we are not talking. Once we stop talking, or once we reduce the time given to them, they find alternatives. One day one mother, she brought her son to my clinic for counseling. Her main complaint is, this fellow, he doesn't wake up early in the morning. I asked him, why don't you wake up by 6 o'clock at least? Then he said, uncle, I wake up at 5 o'clock, but I pretend that I am sleeping. Why? Because the moment I get up, my parents, my father and mother are ready to take class. My mother is nagging, my father is ragging, therefore I am lagging behind, so I am keeping quiet. And he said, uncle, you have to do counseling to my mother and father also. I said, kya problem hai? My mother, she keeps telling the same thing repeatedly, wo band karna. How my father always keeps telling about his past. Hamara jamane mein kya, see, they heard thousands of times. You see, children are clapping now, not the adults. Because they are these victims. Never play that cassette again and again. They know very well. We used to respect, we used to wear knickers. Even now we can wear knickers, they don't mind. But they want jeans because they're sons of great people. Talk. 3rd T is touch. Touch them here. Touch them here. Touch both eyes and ears. Touch. Now that touch gives you more energy. And that touch, that vibration gives you energy to manage your stress. When you go home, you're tired. Your child takes your hand into her hand, little hand, and squeezes gently, daddy, aaj kya hua hamara school mein, a teacher. See, you enjoy this. Instead, some parents, they say, after all, he has got only one father. So let him enjoy, and we should also enjoy. 4th T is trust. Believe that your children are more intelligent than you. Because they are more informed and they belong to this generation. Right? When we were kids, we were not allowed to touch even radio. In my house, there was a radio, bush radio. Switching on is this, switching off this. We know this, but my father never allowed us to touch, because during those days, this radio was a luxury. Somehow I grew. Later, after my marriage, then the TV has come. So one day I was trying to change the channels. My son, who was in 3rd class, he said, hey, daddy, don't touch it. I said, okay, Baba, I know the manual. I have manual here. My dad. No, no, daddy, please leave it, leave it. I will do it. Then I said, are you useless fellow? When we were kids, we were not allowed to touch radio. And now I am an adult. You are not touching me. You are going to touch TV. So when our generation will learn? Then he said, daddy, you forget about it. We are all here to help you. Remember, this is the knowledge which they acquired from the environment. Mark Twain says, my school never interfered with my education. It's the greatest statement. He said, my school never interfered with my education. Education is not the ranks you obtain in the class. It is something beyond, something beyond. touch, then trust, I mean, then teach. Teach them values, why Rama is great, why Jesus is great, why Islam religion is great, why Sikhs are great. Teach them, tell them we are Indians. Teach them about integrity. Read books, Tenal Ramakrishna, Akbar Birbal stories. And finally, treat. Treat is, don't treat like father. Father and son, when you say father and son, there is some bonding and there is also, that relationship also makes them to maintain the distance. Treat them as friend. Let him talk to you. Let him share his feelings. Let her share her feelings. Other day one girl, when she was in 10th class, she got a message from a boy, I love you. She talked to her mother, mommy, somebody sent a message. Mother so furious, so serious, so emotional, so sensitive, she came to school and fought with the teachers. Never fight with the teachers. Then teachers stopped talking to that girl. Instead, they banged her, why did you bring to a cell phone to the school? And boys also, they made fun of her. So she changed the school. In the next school also, she got a message. Then she asked father, daddy, I want to talk to you. Then father said, I am very busy. Then she started sharing with neighbor's boy and finally